Like we're monsters. Well, I saw a Fox News van drive down my street yesterday.
Well, at least they're on our side.
True.
Look, it's that guy from Talk to the Ham.
Thank you.
Greetings, feckless youth of Indiana.
What are you doing here?
Just out for a stroll, enjoying the sweet, fetid scent of Americana. I'm from a small town myself, you know.
We're not interested.
Okay, I know we have a ideological divide that I believe we can bridge if we just get to know each other. I'll begin. I'm an actor. My instrument was forged in the fiery furnace that is Juilliard. I'm sure your drama teacher has told you that institution.
We don't have a drama program.
Oh, that explains the complete lack of empathy. We're building a bridge. Who are you?
Kaylee.
That's your name. Tell me who you are. Like, pretend I'm gonna play Kaylee in the story of Kaylee. Help me prepare.
I'm a girl, a teenager, I'm a cheerleader.
And why do you hate homosexuals?
Hey, I'm a good person, right, Shelby? We all are.
We go to church.
We're Christians.
Now we're getting somewhere. This is something I know about. Christians follow the teachings of Christ, correct?
Yeah.
Well, I have had the opportunity to play Christ on 3 occasions. My current messianic run in the non-equity tour of Godspell. Last year's Hallmark Easter special, that one was animated. And Temptation, the musical stage telling of the last temptation of Christ. I have been crucified 3 times. 12 if you count the reviews. Okay, anyway, my point. I got to know JC really well, and I have to say that I don't think he hated anyone, let alone gays.
But the Bible says that homosexuality is wrong, and we follow the Bible.
I am sure that there are rules in the Bible that you all break every day.
Well, that's different.
Is it? You can't cherry pick the Bible deciding which parts you want to believe.
We don't do that.
You don't? What's this? Kaylee has a small tattoo. That tattoo would be taboo. Kaylee, guess what waits for you? An eternity in the fiery pits of hell.
Hey!
Shelby, you seem sweet to me. But if it has come to be, you've lost your virginity. We'll be stoning you and your family as well.
What?
Or we could use some common sense instead. When you're lost, it always helps recalling those immortal words that Jesus said. There's one rule that trumps them all. Love thy neighbor trumps them all. Love thy neighbor, trust them all!
You know, you make a lot of sense. What are you talking about? You're not even a little bit sorry for Emma. You guys, like, used to hang out. That was before she turned gay. Maybe she was always gay.
Exactly, because that's how God made her, Shelby.
Hey, Trent, what's going on?
Oh, it's the cast of Godspell. They'll back me up.
What kind of white nonsense are you starting
now? He's just trying to confuse us. My stepdad always says
that... Your stepdad? You mean your parents are divorced?
Yeah, so?
I'm afraid that's a big no-no. Not to oversimplify, but the scripture does imply that your mom will have to die. How's tomorrow if she's not got other plans? See, there's no way to separate which rules you can violate. Let's hope you don't masturbate, cause the Bible says we'll have to cut off your hands, or we could use some common sense instead. When you're lost, it always helps recalling those immortal words Jesus said. There's one rule that's right. thy neighbor, trust them all.
Love thy neighbor.
Yeah. Love thy neighbor, trust them all.
Love thy neighbor.
Love thy neighbor.
Love thy neighbor.
Love thy neighbor is the one that trumps the law.